Greetings, dear ones. I'm Kryon of Magnetic Service. My partner is apprehensive. He steps aside, but he's listening. I feel him. I know him. The apprehensiveness is because of the revelations, perhaps of his past, that he has not heard before. And yet it is written in his Akash to be read. And there are those who could have read it. I do not reveal anything that is not appropriate. And the revelation of his past is only to enhance the information given this evening about the place that I sit in. This channel will not be long, but filled with things for you to think about, ponder. And one of the big questions is this: were you part of it, what I'm going to reveal? There are those in the room who will be nodding and going, I knew it, I knew it, I knew it. I want to tell you about what you already know. Old souls in the room, you understand, do you not, that you tend to incarnate in groups? The groups incarnate over and over in specific areas for specific reasons. Sometimes they move on, sometimes they do not. I will tell you that the area that you are in right now tends to have karmic groups stay. And there's a reason. Some of you have been here literally for 2,000 years. You keep incarnating, joining the societies of what I will call the island. Learning the languages, moving around. And that's for a reason. And I'm going to explain as best I can. We have given you the history of the planet spiritually many times. We've given you the timeline up to a certain way and place, starting with the seeding of the planet with the Lemurian existence, with the Pleiadians, all over. Starting what you now call a planet of free choice, one where you can control your own consciousness and make decisions that will eventually affect the entire galaxy. We've told you that your planet is one of many who have gone through this process. But still, you sit here in 3D and you say, it's a nice story. I'm going to enhance the story. I would like to say this was a story of the UK. It is not. It is a story of the island. It is a story of the region. A place on the planet before borders. Before the names. But including all of the areas from the south of Plymouth to the Tok of Wick. A vast area whose borders have changed a number of times since this all began. When the Lemurians spread upon this planet and spread out, when the other seed colonies settled, and human life began with the knowledge of light and dark, and the societies started to develop. This was a special place. And I'm going to tell you why. There are grids that overlap in specific ways beyond the ones that I teach. Ancient ones, some set by Pleiadians, some set by men, ley lines and grids, some deep into the planet, some we would call portals, some vortices, vortex. Many have moved since ancient times, but there are so many here, and there's a reason. The area, the region, lays in a way that the grids enhance it. You're not going to understand this, and I'm going to give you some metaphysics today and some physics today, whether you're ready for it or not. There are parts of the earth that hide secrets very well. You might call it a cooperative Gaia energy or not, whatever you call it. There are places on the planet which keep the deepest secrets available. As human beings chose their own consciousness, what they would do with it, where they would go with it, from the days of the creation and the thousands of years that followed, humanity decided to place the consciousness at a lower level than it was given to them. Things had to be hidden. And you know this. There are some of you in this room who know this. And the reason you do is it resounds in your Akash, and you were there. There are places of the planet that hide secrets very well. There are secrets at the bottom of the Mediterranean Sea yet to be revealed. There are secrets in Greece, in Egypt, and here. And when it became obvious that human consciousness was sinking to a level where the light was in trouble, you went underground. And these are the areas that had to take the secrets of the mystery schools and hide them. And you did. And the societies that were here were the ones that would do the best job in keeping them hidden. And so many names for them, dear ones. There are no correct or incorrect names, for the societies are all, some of them were false societies with false names so people wouldn't go near them. All of that to hold a light. Today, the revelations of what you can do with your DNA, the reprogramming, all that, mining the Akash, the God inside, these were the secrets that could never be put forward to a low consciousness humanity. From Plymouth in the south to Wick in the north, the whole island participated. There are so many portals here. There's so much energy still here. And the mysteries were hidden. You ask yourself about the purpose of druids. You ask yourself the purpose of the mythology in the 1100s of Merlin. Not a man at all, but a combination of concepts about magic. What was the magic? What we teach today, metaphysics. That's where you sit. And you hit it well. Now, who is here in the room are the masters of hiding. Your Akash is deep with it, dear ones. I've waited a long time to sit in this chair, in this place, and congratulate you for keeping this pure. And you did. And you know it when you walk around here. It's special here. Don't you know this? Now, I would like to introduce you to a family member who sits next to me, the man in the chair. He's everything Brit, from the bottom of Plymouth to the top of Wick. He is a product, and his Akash is a product of all of the countries here and their colonies. His last specific life, he knows all about. We've even published it as an Australian. We haven't published, or he doesn't even know, the lifetimes as a colonist when he was black. Always a Brit or part of the colonies. And today he sits in the chair, a product of the colonies. Always a Brit. It is his job to keep secrets, and he's good at it. We've revealed his lifetime in Lemuria as the secret keeper and the runner of the messages to royalty, keeping their secrets, running with the verbal messages they needed to pass one to another. He knew the secrets of the mystery schools. He's been everything you can imagine. He's participated in the Knights of the Templar. He's been a third degree Mason. You name it, he's been it. He has kept the secrets of the land. He knows this land very well. It's in his Akash. He's more familiar than he even knows with the tucks in the valleys of the countryside, the feeling of the dirt, the cold winters. He knows them well. He has yet to discover it. You remember, do you not, the irony here, a world traveler he is, and we have kept him away from the UK. We've kept him away from Ireland, not quite on the island, but close. We've kept him away from Scotland. We've kept him away from the places that he would resound to and remember, where he kept the secrets well. But dear ones, I want you to know, this is not about him. It's about you, for he was with you keeping him. Now, why do I tell you this? Before I reveal the message's culmination, and what I want this land to know and the secret keepers to understand, before I do that, I want to give you some multidimensional physics in a way you have never heard before, and that will tie in to what some have said is coincidence and others have said is fakery. I want to talk about crop circles. You think I wouldn't? Oh. First, let us look at the coincidences, and there are none. It's time to connect the dots. First of all, tell me this. When did they begin? In numbers, what was the time frame? And what a coincidence that it started just before the harmonic convergence, just before the 18 years of this, which is half the half cycle of the precession of the equinoxes, the 36-year window. And they began right before the shift, in numbers. Second question. Where predominantly on this planet are they? And the answer is here. What a coincidence. In the lands that were built to keep the secrets of the mystery schools. What are they? First of all, let me tell you what they are not. They are not created in the middle of the night in the darkness by two guys with sticks and ropes and bottles of beer. You knew that. If it were possibly to technologically look upon the paddocks and the fields. In the night, with infrared or whatever you call it, if you could record, you'd see something. And we've told you this before, and we wish you to verify it. They're created within moments. Stamps in the grass all at once, with no one around. If you could capture this on video, you would see the earth sink, all within moments, all together. Perhaps it's the first time you've heard that. Watch for the validation. Now I'm going to tell you a little bit about the potentials of what they are. And this is difficult. Are they messages? Of course, of course. Do they contain language? In a way, yes, they do. Sacred? Not the ground they are on, but the messages they contain, yes. Messages about all things in the future. Wisdom, sacred geometry, it is all there, even DNA. How do I explain this? I want you to go slow, my partner, for this is new. I'm going to give you some examples. 13 months before you got a new pope, I told you you were going to get a new pope. Now I'm going to ask you, was that predestination? No. Was it fortune telling? No. Because we could see the potentials that were brewing in the private areas you could not see regarding the papal seat, regarding the consciousness of the one who would step down, regarding the potentials of the one who would come forward from South America. What a coincidence that is. And we told you about it. So you might say that there was a 90% potential of that happening. From the other side of the veil, it was obvious. It carried energy of potential. We gave it to you, and it took place. We saw it before it happened. We were able to because of the physics of multidimensional potential energy. When there is a potential, no matter what kind of energy, it has physics in multidimensionality. Real physics. It carries an energy, the potential does, of something happening. It becomes reality on your clock, a three-dimensional clock that does not exist in a multidimensional state. In a multidimensional state, potentials that are more than 90% have already happened. Difficult to explain, isn't it? Not long ago, we told you there would be another small war in the Middle East. You got to see it last month. Was that fortune-telling? Is there predestination? And the answer is no. Just like the Pope, we saw the things taking place under the bonnet where no one else knew the consciousness of what was being developed, the players, all of that. And we were able to tell you 90% that it would take place. And it did. In pure multidimensional physics that you do not understand yet, there are quantum formulas for the energy of potential. And when they reach a certain point, they manifest themselves in a way where you can say, this is happening. Let's say, for instance, you were in a building where they were rehearsing a choir. A choir of thousands, they were about ready to sing a beautiful song. You heard the rehearsal, you knew it was coming. And they were going to flip a switch where the whole town could hear the song, and they were going to do it at a certain time. And you saw all of this. You might have sat in on the rehearsals. Maybe you were privileged. And you sat in the corner and you watched it all envelop. The clock started to come close to that place where they would sing the practiced song in all of its glory and its beauty. And you escaped the building to go outside and tell the people that at a certain time there was going to be a beautiful song. Now stop for a moment. Is this predestination? Would they believe you? Maybe, maybe not. And after it took place, and it would they think you were a fortune teller? Maybe, maybe not. But what do you think? For you saw the 90% potential. The song had been rehearsed. It was about ready to be sung. The clock was ticking to the point of its release. And you knew it was coming. This has formulation in quantum physics. It's the energy of a potential. A train that cannot be stopped because the potentials are there. All of this to tell you about crop circles. How do I explain this? There's a song about to be sung on this planet of light. It may take a generation, dear one, but it's on its way. It's 90%. I wouldn't be here if it were not. Yes, you have free choice. But the odds that you will change it are amazingly against this, for the snowball is rolling. And we see it in all of the corners on the planet. We see the alliances for peace. We see consciousness starting to change. The metaphor of the beautiful song about to be sung is being rehearsed on the planet. Amongst all of the terror, all of the darkness, all of that which squirms in the dark because you have too much light, dear ones. It knows it's going to lose. Don't tell it. The best way to stop it is to take away its funding. We have said this before. Find out where it's coming from and stop it. That's the best way. Watch for this, even in your news, soon. They'll figure it out. Why fund the dark when there is so much light? There is so much light. Now, follow my reasoning. Based upon everything I have said to you, follow my reasoning. If there is a potential for a high human consciousness for peace on earth, if it lays out there, if it's 90%, it is formulated. It is there in physics. It is stamping the messages in the grass to you right now, saying this is the future. Messages from beyond, messages from you, the potential that has already been manifest in a certain way, metaphysically. I'll tell you what the messages say. And that is why I sit in the chair today. It is time to release all of the secrets of the Mystery School. And it's hard. Because the generations that you have spent hiding things is in your Akash. You've segmented it. You've societized it. You've called it names. You've stuffed it away. And now I am saying it is time to release it. This is not your grandfather's metaphysics. This is the new age. This is the time the ancients have waited for. You've kept the secrets for a reason. Now, secret keepers, I want you to walk out of this place with a new concept of who you are and what you're for. It's time to share what you know. And the best way to do it is to live mastery. How you treat people, the way that you can heal your body, all of the shamanic information that you have kept hidden and sequestered for all of these years, release it. Let those around see the majesty in you. The secrets are out. Say them out loud if anybody asks. You can change your DNA. You can change your reality. You can change your life. You can change your lifespan. That's Merlin. That's magic. All right here. That's the message. Drop the walls. We said this last night, sitting in another country, across the channel, drop the walls. Join with others that you never would have joined with before. Watch for synchronicity of love. Is it possible that there are those around you who wear odd garb and perhaps have other religious beliefs or spirituality that are filled with God and have the secrets you do? Watch for it. For they're ready to release it too. This message that I'm giving you is not sequestered to KRYON. It is being shouted in the grass. It is being given to mediums everywhere. This is the time you waited for. KRYON, what is it we're supposed to do in 3D? I just told you. Walk out of this room and live like a master. Watch what you say. Watch how quick you are or slow you are to anger. Look for God in others. Start solving problems in your life that others will look at you and say, I don't know what you're into, but I want a piece of it. And you can say, ah, it's magic. And you'd be right. It is magic. Imagine a human being who can extend their years with their mind, with the intuition they have through the higher self portal, through bringing in energy from the past, through applying light to their life, a light that they have kept hidden for centuries. Let it out. Let it out. Combine with those you would never combine with. There are those who would say, well, others are doing it wrong and their metaphysics is not like yours. It's time to drop the barriers and see God in them. Don't look at their belief. Look at their heart. Awareness precedes change. Someone in the audience knows exactly where I got that. That was for you, dear. What are you going to do next? This is the awareness cycle. Next comes change. Leave the place. Leave this place different than you came in. We said that already. This is the purpose of the meeting. In the next weeks and months, some of the things that I have said today will become alive for you. You will see them manifesting in ways you didn't expect, and you'll remember the moment. This message is given in love for this area. For you, right now, it is one that is congratulatory for holding the light so well for so long. Now let it go. Shine. My partner is with you in all of it. And so it is.